Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today we continue with the series of videos about RAG, Retrieval Augmented Generation, and today we will look at the Llama Index and working together with OpenAI to do something that we already cover on the channel, that is extract information from PDFs or any other kind of documents, is what we say. What we name speak with your own documents. We are going to create a small RAG agent using these technologies, and then this way we will be able to compare, as we already did this with LangChain and with Gemini. We are going to do today this with other technologies, as I said, Llama Index and OpenAI models. Llama Index is similarly to LangChain, is a framework to build RAG agents or components, AI or generative AI components, and is doing essentially this so connecting the different technologies that you may need to use when you are working with the objective to create a RAG or an AI agent, which is essentially for what is designed. Similarly, it works very similar to LangChain. For those that are familiar with the LangChain, like is in my case, for what I see, is pretty similar. Probably a little bit more easy to work with, but it's just first impression. If you are familiar with the concepts, what is how it's connecting with LLMs, with embeddings models, with vector stores, with other technologies, is practically the same. You will not see anything different here. Preference, I can't say today. Obviously, I know better LangChain, so I will say today. Better LangChain than Llama Index, but yeah, it's a little bit premature to say this after we don't cover more use cases and connecting with different technologies. How easy not easy is work with Llama Index? For what I see on this video, and you will see in this example, in this tutorial, it's pretty easy to use. If you got the concepts, or you work before with a technology in this area, like LangChain or Semantic Kernel, is exactly the same. You will see now that we connect to the LLMs. Small differences in how you configure the components, but at the end of the day, it's very similar. Again, I cannot say today who is better. We will see in after doing some more stuff with Llama Index, and then we will be able to decide. Maybe you know already. You are more profit or more pro in Llama Index than in LangChain, and you can make a comparison. Again, I will be doing a series of videos covering different use cases, as I did with LangChain, and today is a kind of introduction to the technology and create a small RAG component, which is the replica to something that we already did on the channel. We are going to work with PDFs and let's move. So here again, I create this notebook that later on I will upload as usual to the repository, and you can later on download to your local environment and replicate, install the libraries, and play with the technology. So here you have the libraries you need to replicate this notebook, or to use this notebook in your local environment. And here just a small comment about the versions. Say when I installed first time, I didn't point to a version in Llama Index. I just installed directly Llama Index without a version, and caused some issues, just to let you know. So the latest release is done. It was released yesterday, to the yesterday, 25th of October, and it has some issues with the settings. So it, at least on my case, I'm working on Windows with Anaconda, Python 11, and well, in my case, Index didn't import, so that's why I decided to go to some of the one of the previous versions. This version is from beginning of October, as you can see here, and this is working without any problem. Okay, so we use .m to load the OpenAI API key. We read it into a config into a dictionary with the .m values, just pointing to the .m file. Here with we import the OpenAI and OpenAI embeddings classes to connect to the model. Just notice different one of the main differences I observed is the temperature. By default in LangChain is 1, here the temperature is 0.1. probably is is something that here you don't have in this class other parameters, like you had to pass the parameters like top p, top k, do through, like a dictionary. Is they don't have a parameter on the class itself, and there is additional parameters that you can review. Here I pass you the link to the documentation. You can get into the specific class in LangChain, in Llama Index, and review how to do. But well, to instantiate a model, you can observe here on the cell that is exactly the same that we do what we do with working with the LangChain. Here a small difference. This is pretty similar to, I don't know who copied to who, but it's the same that we do in the semantic kernel, the Microsoft semantic kernel. You just create an object here, and then on settings object, and in the setting object you just plug or assign LLM, the embed model, and you will see that is settings. You had plenty of attributes that you can instantiate, and then on once you have this instantiated, you don't need to pass or to the object anymore. Here we use the library itself contains a vector store index to work in memory to vectorize the documents or text, and this is if you don't say anything, obviously, like any other vector store is working on memory, and also we have here a folder reader. Here it works with multiple kinds of documents, and the concept is exactly the same. You just read, in this case I'm reading PDFs. One PDF I have here in data. This is something, again, we are replicating something that we already did on the channel, but today with other technologies, this is public information about one company. And then on here we are going to read the PDF, parse the PDF, unload the data. Here what you get is a list of the here Llama Index documents. If you do the same with the similar or the equivalent in LangChain, you will get a list of LangChain documents. Here you have a list of Llama Index documents. The concept exactly the same that the concept that is embedded on the LangChain technology. You can see here is creating probably more rich metadata. You can see here the ID, embeddings node, none, metadata, page, file name, path, file type, PDF, file size, creation date. So it's much more rich metadata using the class. So one difference as well, when you work with PDFs in Llama Index, you don't need to install anything additional. All the logic is already embedded on the technology, on the library. In Llama in LangChain, you need to install additionally a library to work with PDFs. Here, if you want to work with docs, with Microsoft Word documents, you need to install this. But in my case, as I'm reading PDFs, I didn't need to install any additional library. So you can see here the data. Here is a list of documents, Llama index documents, and here we just create the vector store from our documents. Here we make a simple query. Here just find the three top similar documents according to the query that you pass here. And then here is interacting already the query engine with the LLM and returning an answer. Here we do something similar, but in this case we are going to create an agent with memory. We use the chat memory buffer, which is included in the as well on the core module of Llama Index. So when you install the Llama, is probably here, installation and setup. Once you install Llama Index, it's coming with all these classes. So there is also third-party integrations, but you already have practically everything that you need. It's already embedded on the library. In any case, there is a open source community as well, the similar to what we had in the community, LangChain community, and when we need to explore some specific components, we will go there. But for the time being, I didn't need to install anything additional to work with the, at least with PDFs. Probably in the next videos where we work with audio or video, probably we need to install something additionally. Okay, we create our memory, our condensed plus context chat engine, using our vector store as retriever, the memory, and LLM. Here we make a prompt, and we simply use chat engine, chat prompt, and we print the response. Is responding correctly. I check it out. Use your own documents in that case and interrogate or speak with your documents and see what did you get. Also, you need to play here with the parameters of OpenAI in this case, because some of the questions, like you will see here, this is also the second prompt. Is correct, but this one, for example, that when we did the same exercise with LangChain and Gemini, that works properly. So we got the answer here. It's not getting the answer. There is two choices here. Either here, maybe we can extract more documents. The top five documents and provide more context to the model, or simply that the temperature is pretty low here, is 0.1. Probably we need to configure probably better the model. But in any case, I left you play with that. It's up to you here. The same. We ask for the appointments, is including correctly who is appointed at the board of directors, but is including something that probably is not not completely correct. But again, that's probably part of my configuration. I will play later with the parameters just to see where is exactly the issue. But for the purpose of the video, what I wanted to show you how to make it, to to link the different components and create a small rack agent. It's pretty simple. You see, not many lines of code. It's really straightforward. In that aspect, I think is easy to use in comparison with LangChain. LangChain sometimes is a little bit cryptic, especially if you use the LangChain language to build the chains. But here is it's pretty straightforward. You just use the classes, configure, and then on. Yeah, it's working fine and easy to use. No? In any case, the final advice about what is better, probably there is no better here. No? It's both of them are really good technologies, and only probably the differences would be the kind of integrations they had with third-party technologies. In this case, for what I saw, is integrating with the commercial, not commercial models, a number of technologies, vector stores, APIs. So it's going to be very difficult to decide which one is better. No? In terms of the usability, my first impression, as I said, is a little bit more easier to work with Llama Index. But well, let's see. We will do more stuff with Llama Index in the near future. So we'll see, and you will see as well if you are following this job, which one is better. So today we did this in 20 minutes, no more, to create a RAS component. Because obviously there is already a base. If you work before with other technology like LangChain or semantic kernel, it's pretty easy to understand and how you have to link the different components. Okay, that's pretty much all. I hope that you find it useful, interesting, and especially useful for your job, for your training, for whatever reason are you watching this video. And if so, just give me a like, subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before, and make comments and share with your friends or colleagues just to help me to grow in YouTube. I will upload this now to the repo, and I will put a link into the comments to this material in order you to be able to replicate what you saw in the video in your local environment. Okay, thank you very much, and see you soon.